Our current power grid is basically a giant fire hose of electricity going from power plants to your house. But what if it were efficient, two-way, and let you use your neighbor's solar panels? That's the smart grid! Sup guys, Trace here. In 2003, a tree limb touched a high-voltage power line in Ohio, causing a cascading blackout that stretched across the Northeast from New York to Chicago and as far north as Ottawa, Canada. 50 million people were without power for as long as 2 days. The estimated cost? $6 billion and 11 lives. You could blame the tree branch, the people in Ohio who should have trimmed that tree branch, or even the faulty alarm system, but really, we should just blame ourselves. The North American power grid is... well, it's a mess. In 1882, Thomas Edison built the first commercial power grid in New York City, introducing the idea of electricity distribution. Now, almost 140 years later, it's been built ad hoc, jury-rigged, and turned into two major grids, the Eastern and Western interconnection, and three minor grids, Texas, Alaska, and Quebec interconnections. Together, they comprise $1 trillion of hard work for public and private groups, all to provide power to us in the US and Canada, and it's dumb, real dumb. Right now, our power grid provides 830 gigawatts of electricity to more than 330 million people, and yet, there's no storage system. Dumb. If you flip on your light switch, the local power plant has to ramp up production just a bit to power that light. Also, all the power only flows one way, from generators to stations to your house, like an electricity fire hose. Dumb. If something breaks, they can't just run power around the problem. They have to drive out and find it and fix it. Things like this are immensely frustrating for utilities, regulators, and governments, and of course, you and me. Which is why we need a smart grid. A smart grid is to the current dumb grid as the newest smartphones are to Zach Morris's massive beige brick thing. Actually, no, Zach Morris's phone was still sweet. Our grid, not. The smart grid basically adds internet-connected computers into the mix. The utility company sends power and information to the houses then. And then the houses send that information back to tell them how they're doing and how much they're using and also where the power is coming from. On top of that, if you have solar power on your roof or wind power or whatever, the power grid knows that. And if it goes out, the grid will know you're okay and even ask you to help power homes and facilities nearby, like traffic lights or emergency services. Computers at every point on the grid would know where they are in relation to privately owned home batteries or solar panels, and they'd be able to communicate with those too. This internet-connected grid could revolutionize how power is generated and distributed and make the whole trillion-dollar mess more efficient. Right now, 6.1% of all power is lost as the electricity physically runs through the lines, heating them up and generating noise. That's about $19.5 billion disappearing just from the lines themselves. With computers talking back and forth to the utilities, everyone would know second by second to only route power as needed, perhaps from local storage or solar, rather than burning coal far, far away because one guy is watching TV. It might seem obvious, but this means good things for companies, people, even the environment. For example, if the grid knew that there were batteries available, the power plants wouldn't need to burn as much coal. Or if the grid knew it was windy or sunny, it could pull from local renewable farms. You could even, as a consumer, choose to only use power from local storage or charge your car when the cost was lower. Honestly, it sounds like a crazy nerdy dream, right? Which is sort of where we are now. Countries all over the world are trying to get their citizens excited about this new smart infrastructure, but it's hard and expensive. Ultimately, the smart grid will save money, but it will also help us use distributed power generation and help the environment by eliminating waste and encouraging people to understand more about how they're using their own electricity. If you're coming out of this thinking, wait, but if the grid is dumb and crazy now, how does it even work? You're in luck, my friend. Remember that blackout during the Super Bowl? We looked into how the power grid worked back then. Check it out. We're using a lot more power now, and it's only gonna grow. We use AC power.
Go Tesla!
Because it's easier to generate and move around. To make electricity, you spin a coil wire inside of another coil, and you get power. Do you wanna put solar power on your roof, or get a battery for your house? Or are you just into renewables, or are you really into coal? Let us know down in the comments, and keep coming back here every day for more DNews.